organizer of this fashion show. She's a London-based show business promoter. Her name is Mayeni Sisi, but better known here as Malisha the Queen. Malisha, tell me, why are you organizing this fashion show?
Actually, it's not only a fashion show, it's also a disabled priority. They live good, they have good health, good everything. But here they don't give them any opportunities, nothing at all, no good places to stay, always begging in the street.
And how do you think this show you're organizing will help change that at all?
It will not help change everything, but I want to raise money. I want to come here every year to raise money. Any money I'm raising today is going to support the disabled. My organization, like Malisha the Queen Charitable Organization, because I'm into fashion industry, beauty pageant in London, I'm the CEO of the Miss London Board of Beauty Pageant, also the CEO of Miss Sierra Leone. I want to make changes. I want to do a lot of things.
And who is helping you do this? Have you got funds or support from the government or any private sector at all?
At the moment, no. I'm doing it all on my own with the support of the chairman of the Disabled Commission, the Persons with Disability. She emailed me also the good thing I'm saying I'm now with the Council of the Persons with Disability and also the president for the Power Olympic Disabled and Ball Team.
Alright, Mayeni Sisi, aka Malisha the Queen, thank you very much for your time. She's the chief organizer of the Fashion Beat Show going on here. And like I said, in the next 3 to 4 hours, hopefully, this place will go and go. Over to you, Bola. Much actually. The government in recent times set up the Disability Commission, which aims to look at the problems besetting the disabled people in this country with the hope that funds will be put together to look after them. But for now, I'm afraid there is none. You've been all over Freetown, you see people who are victims of the war and those who are suffering from poliomyelitis, paralyzed, waist down, begging on the street to feed, without which I'm afraid they can't live and they will die.